I never really planned to become a content creator for YouTube, but it just happened. It all started in 2010 when I made a film about the barrel making procedures of the Pedersoli factory. And since that time, many things changed, but I'm still a military history professor and I still run my family-owned business dealing with historical arms and accessories. But content creating also became an important part of my life. I met Pierangelo Pedersoli for the first time in 2003 in Halikko, Finland. It was the MLAIC European Championships. That was the first ever international match I attended, and I was completely lost, if I remember right. I remember that we had a very good talk about the past and the future of historical shooting and historical hunting. And he was a very inspiring man. Of course, he loved making business, but he was also very passionate for building good quality and authentic firearms for his shooters. That passion he inherited from his father, Davide, is now being passed to his son, Stefano, who is deeply involved in running the company now. So the Pedersoli name actually today marks a three-generation dynasty, gun-making dynasty. And they are still working for the shooters, with the shooters. After the success of the barrel-making video, in 2013, exactly 10 years ago, I returned to the factory to make a film about the woodworking procedures. And I really suggest you to watch both videos because they tell a lot about the quality behind their manufacturing procedures. But today I'm returning to the factory to see what changed in the past decade and to see where they are going today. So ladies and gentlemen, follow me to Gardoneva Trompia via Artigiani 57, the Pedersoli headquarters. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the heaven of replica manufacturing in Gardoneva Trompia in the Pedersoli factory. And the occasion today why I'm here with my friend Stefano Pedersoli is that exactly 10 years ago, in 2013, I was here recording the manufacturing process of the factory. And actually that was the video that started the Capangle YouTube channel. That was the first successful video. And it is still a very good video, I think, because it shows many, many small details about the art of making guns. And now we are here again. So Stefano, thank you very much for the invitation.
Thank you so much for your visit. You are always welcome here.
Thank you. It's very good to be here because I will show you around. In this small room, there are at least 100 guns, 100 guns that I want to own sometime in my life. So this is a childhood's dream. Okay, so what will be our today's topic?
Oh, today we are going to visit the production department that in the last 10 years changed a little bit because like every company, every modern company have to invest money in technologies to be always competitive in terms of quality, in terms of lead time. So you can see what happened in the last period.
This will be, I think, a good insight just for you to see how much knowledge and how much technology is behind making a historical firearm, which can be done by hand also. But I think that this is the state-of-the-art modern time manufacturing process that we are going to see with the heritage that you cherish for many, many hundred years here in Gardona.
Yes, for sure. We have never lose our heritage in terms of handworks, you know, but we are a production company that export all around the world, huge quantities, so we have to work and we have to push the technology too. So it's a kind of mix between the modern technology as the handworks. We have cleaned the glasses for the occasion. You see every light, it's very...
Yeah, like it's always there.
No powder on the windows. Usually it's not like this. No, I'm joking.
Only black powder.
Only black powder. Okay, here is where we cut the rod. This is the beginning of the barrel production. The barrel is very important for us, and the quality of the rod, the research for having the good material, it's very important. During the last 2 years, like every company in the world that work in the metal, we had several problems to have the metal, to have the material for working. Anyway, we arrived to do it, we have it. We work generally with 39 chrome vanadium 4, and we have enough material for the production of 2023. That is very, very important. It's always a fight, but we are here to fight, okay? After the COVID, we have several problems to fight the steel and the metal, generally speaking, around the world. By the way, the material is still available, and increasing the research in terms of material, we arrive to have it. The material cost much more compared to the past, But if you want to stay on the market, we must have the material for work. This is what we are doing.
Let's check now how these metal pieces are sliced into proper size parts.
Yes.
That's a new machine that you have there.
It's a new machine, new technology, a modern technology. Everything is automatic. And it's very, very important for the safety of the operator. Okay, in terms of pressure, you know, the muzzle loading guns doesn't create the same pressure of a smoked powder. But in terms of quality of the material and of the broaching process, the rifling process, I think maybe in the muzzle loading guns we must be more precise than with the breech loading. For sure we are precise in the same way. But why I say that in the broaching lung is very critical, because during the loading process, any kind of mistake of lack in terms of quality is very well touchable during the ramrod movement of the inside the barrel. This is why the barrel must be perfect inside. The rifling must be perfect. And everything starts from the quality of the material.
Yeah.
We are in the barrel department right now. We have moved here one of the CNC machine used to making the breech plug or some kind of screw. Why is important to have the machine here? Because we want to arrive to better manage the barrel process. So the barrel process must starting and finish here. So all the part that create the complete barrel born here, so the barrel, the corp of the barrel, the tube and the breech plug, so we can arrive to have the part ready for the assembling. Okay, here we have the magazine where we put the rod. The rod are pushed by the machine inside the working area. Everything, this is a CNC machine, it means that the machine is connected to a computer, so everything, all the tolerance, are always under the control of the computer. This is another CNC machine, the one that we use to make the frame of the breech loading guns, like the Sharps, like the 1886, the Borbuster, and the lighting in the futures. This is the first on the Highland of two machines. We are going to receive a second machine, same like this. And on this area, we are going to create a special processing area with two machines connected to an automatic warehouse where we arrive to put all the tools, all the towers like this that we need to assemble in the part that must be work on the machine. On this way, we arrive to work 24 hours per day. The number of pieces made during the day, the quality, everything are going to be under the control of the computer that, how we say, have the power and have the control of both the machine and the warehouse in the meantime. On this tower, we assembling few receiver from the 1886 and few from the Sharps models, okay? During the day and during the production process, we just have to move the position on the towers from one position to the others, arriving to cover the 99% of the process. Everything is made here. When the receiver is removed from the tower, from the machine, we just have to cleaning a little bit the surface, but all the parts are worked, all the holes are drilled, everything is done. In the next future, with two machines and different kind of tools, we arrive to producing around, for every machine, around 12 and 16 frame, working 24 hours per day.
Yeah.
Here we can see the beginning of the receiver. This is from the Sharps, this is from the lever action. Okay, it's the archaic form of the receiver, but you can understand how much material we must cut from the beginning. Here we are at the beginning of the barrel process. We have cut the rod and we have drilled the rod inside. The boring is almost finished. I say almost because the surface after the drilling process is not good. When I say good, it means that must be clean like a mirror. So after the first part of the drilling process, we must polishing with special tools, special stones, the bore inside to having the surface really clean. That's really important for the muzzle loading gun. For several persons, the quality of a muzzle loading gun and the process doesn't need to be the same of a breech loading gun. You say, oh, you know, a muzzle loading is a muzzle loading. Absolutely not. It's the opposite. Because the quality in a muzzle loading gun and in a muzzle loading barrel is in your hand. When you load the barrel, any kind of defect is under the control of the user. So you must be really straight when you do, when you work in the muzzle loading gas, absolutely. Okay, this is the new drilling machine. Is a great jump in terms of technology compared to the past. This machine is much more fast compared to the past and is also more precise. Just to give you an idea, in one day we can arrive to drilling between 70 and 80 barrels, 70 and 80 rods. That is a huge number of barrels. Why is so fast? Because in the meantime, we have the rotation of the tools, of the drilling tools, and of the rod. So both the elements rotate in the meantime, so the drilling processes become very, very fast. Here you can see some of our drilling tool. The barrel must be very clean during the drilling. Using the paper, using a paper filter, we arrive to collect all the minimum part of material removed during the process. Let me stay here for maintaining the barrel inside very clean, for maintaining the drilling tool very clean. Considering that usually for drilling a rod of 1 meter, we need, in the past we need almost something like 1 hour. Right now we arrive to drilling the barrel in 25 minutes, not more. After this process, the internal bore of the rod is really well done, very close to the finishing quality. The final dimension is done with the polishing. Cioè, we calculated the diameter obtaining after the drilling because we know that we have to cutting a little bit of material with the polishing, with the stone at the end of the process. Okay, we have a talk of the polishing part of the process that must be made after the drilling part, the drilling process. And we must polish the barrel inside and outside. That's very important. We must polish in the barrel inside and outside. For example, here we have the stone used for the outside polishing of the barrel. You have to image the barrel that go up and down in the middle of the stone. Okay, the stone are assembling of the machine like this. You must image the barrel that work like this, up and down, and the work that and the stone that work like this. Pam 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 pam. Usually we not polish the barrel in one times. We polish the barrel in two or three times. arriving to the quality that we are looking for. This is the machine used for the polishing inside the barrel. You have the stone that must be assembled like this. We arrive to have the rotation of the rod as the stone works inside the barrel. Like for the machine that work outside, also in this case, we have different kind of stone. You can understand from the different color, from different grade of polishing. Okay, you know Balázs, that the rifling process is one of the most important part of the barrel process working. We use the broach live process for the rifling, and right now we are broaching some barrel from the 4570 Borebuster. The Borebuster is a modern version of our 1886 lever action. Every tool right to cut around 0.06, 0.07 millimeters. Okay, what is very important in terms of quality of the tool is having empty space between one knife and the other, because the pressure during the broaching process is pretty high, because all the cutting material must be concentrated in this area. Is the empty space are not well calculated, you can arrive to have too much pressure inside on the tool, arriving to breaking the tool. And believe me, one of these tools is very, very expensive, as it's not easy to have a new one. From the beginning to the end of every single tool, you have a progression in terms of dimension and deep on the rifling of around 0.06 millimeters. So you can calculate the increment dimension of the knife. This is an Enfield free bend barrel. The barrel is almost finished. Now we have to assemble the breech plug on the barrel. What is very important for having stock and barrel with the sight perfectly alienated is create a reference point between the barrel and the breech plug, that is the part of the rifle assembled with a screw on the stock. Now he's checking that the two parts are perfectly alienated. A part of the CNC machine, we are still using classic technology. Like for example, the straighting machine, that is the one you can see from the brand, that is not a real new machine. Is the one that we still use to finalize the production process of the barrel. So for having the barrel perfectly straight, to 100% of the barrel, we use this kind of machine. Looking inside, looking at the shadow present inside, the conical shadow present inside the barrel, arrive to understand where the barrel is not straight. The complete process want two kind of straightness, one before and one after the rifling process. Okay, this is the department where we made all the steel parts, and the CNC technology is the one use that we have been use since 30 years. During this the last 10 years, we had changed some machine. The technology has been not changed. We are still using the CNC machine with a new CNC machine, a little bit more accurate because are new, nothing more. For example, this is one of the last machine that we have brought few years ago. Okay, also this machine was not present 10 years ago, if I remember. In this department, we have a small CNC machine because we are working a small part. All the spare parts located inside the lock, for example, are made here. So we need several CNC machines of medium and small dimensions. During the last year, we have introduced the laser technology for marking the barrel, for marking the serial number on the barrel. Right now we have two laser machine to covering the entire production. The laser is very precise in terms of quality. The deep of the marks are always the same. Is pretty fast. To every muzzle loading guns produced in Europe that must be proof tested at the CIP proof house, we have to mark the serial number, the logo of the company, the caliber, the country where the barrel is made in Italy, and here the caliber. And on the black powder guns, we always mark it right black powder only, because this kind of guns, the black powder gun, must be used just with black powder and never with smoked powder or any kind of smoked powder. What is important is maintaining the original style of the plate. So we have to recreate the original draw with a computer before to work in the plate, because for our friends reenactor, it's very, very important to maintaining the originally of the historical pieces. Okay, part of the work, some polishings or finishing are made outside, not far from our company, always in Gardone Valtompia. By the way, after any kind of work made outside from the company, we have, before to proceed with the process, to check that the work has been made follow our request. So we keep the material here, and one of our workers that take care of the quality come check the quality before to go the green light to proceed. This is our new electro erosion machine that we use to create very tight and small part. For example, our cook under hammer, the main spring, we cut it directly rounded like this. Why? Because the mainspring usually in the standard position, the mainspring doesn't work. Works just when you load the hammer. It means that the life of the spring become longer and longer. It's nice to see that you can assemble several rod on the machine, and he worked during the night alone without any kind of assistance from the operator. So he can work almost 24 hours per day. Okay, here we are in the wood department. We use CNC technology here to making our stock. Technology with the one we arrived to cover almost the 80-85% of the processed. After that, the last 15% is made by hand, and this is the very this is what gives the value to the stock. What is important to say, we are the one of the only company that make very long stock. For example, the stock from the Frontier and the Kentucky Rifle is just one pieces, without dividing the stock into part. That's from one size give value to the model, but from the other become difficult for us because we had to manage a piece of wood like this. So we must be very careful when we work for not damage the material and for always respecting the tolerance. We have to work the stock assembling the wood in several positions for working to 360 degrees. As I was explaining you before, the last part of the process is covered by the carbon sheet of the worker. For example, here, right now we are finishing a brown bed rifle, a brown bed musket, finishing the part that the machine are not able to work. And this is totally made by hand. You have any kind of gap between the brass and the wood, it's totally made by hand. You can pass your finger without any risk of cutting the skin. This is the last CNC machine. We are still setting the machine. Anyway, this is a new technology. This is a 5-axis machine. It means that the tool may be moved almost everywhere around the piece, and that work everywhere. So with just one position, a fixing position of the wood, we can arrive to work everywhere to 360 degrees. Ok, partiamo da qua. Ok, we are in the assembling department right now. We have several kind of model in assembling, in assembling. For example, Nunzio, that is our the manager of the assembly department, is making the final quality check to some high wall rifle. He's checking all the parts, he's checking the screw, he's checking the letting between the stock and the steel, he's checking the finishing, the general quality. 100% of the guns must be checked under the control of the general manager.
What is the fineness of that finishing paper? How much grit is it?
Che grano ha questa carta?
220.
The crown must be done perfectly in the center of the bore, okay, all around the bore, perfectly alineated. Okay, We have several positions inside the assembly department. Every worker work on a different kind of guns. What is important to say, we have like Ferlac, we have a school here in Gardone Valtrompia where we prepare the worker with specific course for the gun manufacturing here in Gardone Valtrompia. And the young generation step by step take the place of the old one after 3-4 years of study. So we are sure that we are always will have professional worker for the company for the gun company here in Gardone. What he is doing right now is marking barrel and breech plug with a number, the same number, because we must we have to disassembling the two part, continuing the process, and we have to be able to find the current breech plug with the for the barrel later. So this is why we marking a reference number. We are assembling some modern lever action rifle from the Borbuster series. For example, this is the Evolution that is different from the other, because you can see Evolution on the receiver, because the frame is finished with Cerakot and the loading lever is divided into parts. Okay, this is our technical office, that is also our research and development office. For example, right, okay, here we work with 3D machine and 3D technologies. For example, right now Gabriele is recreating a part of the new drop time, the lever action in 3030. He must create a 3D draw before to going in production.
And they use 3D printing to make, let's say, working some those?
Yes, sometimes yes, just to making some prototype, but happen to use the 3D printing. Do you have some part making with 3D printing right now? Okay, this is, you can understand that is a 3D printing from the surface. You can see the line. Okay, the 3D printing is still much expensive for a normal production, but for making, for preparing some prototypes for new models or for making some tests, may be a good solution.
Do you think that one time the 3D printing will replace, let's say, casting, for example?
I don't know. It depending from the jump that technology are going to do in the next future. It depending from the cost. Mm-hmm. Okay, we are in the inletting department right now. Like in the assembly department, we have several kind of product in the department, starting from the breech loading, the lever action rifle. For example, Simone is working to a Borbuster rifle right now, but in the same place, on the side, we can find the stock from a flintlock side by side. So we must be always active. Okay, for guarantee the perfect fitting between the frame and the stock, we must inlet it by hand, like Simone was doing now.
It's very good to see that the machines cannot do everything.
Exactly.
This makes it so human.
So we will survive to the AI, maybe, yeah? With the intention to keep the production always under control, when we change the tool, we make some tests. We are working right now the lever action stock in the wood department, okay? We have changed the tools. Before to proceed, he take one semi-finished stock, he take one frame, he try the inletting process, he say it's fine, so he can give the green light to the worker to proceed with the production. This is why the stock is not finished. This is just at the middle of the process, okay? Usually inletting the receiver where the stock is totally finished. Okay, same quality, same things, same accuracy for what concerns the muzzle loading. Here we are inletting and assembling a brown bass. We must keep attention to the brown bass too and the muzzle loading in general for having the perfect fitting.
So what is the secret of Pedersoli? I believe that the secret is that there are no secrets. They are actually sharing all the knowledge they have. They are just trying to do everything that should be done to make good quality and accessible repros for everybody. They are keeping up the family values, and also they are keeping up the rich gun-making values and traditions of Gardone. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. You've been watching the Cap & Bow YouTube channel. If you like what I do, then please support us through Patreon or by buying our Cap & Bow products. Subscribe, share, like and comment to help the channel grow. Until next time, stay cool and keep your powder dry.